There's an article, like I was doing a little bit of reading. There's a report that a guy called Michael Sadler made to the House of Commons in 1832. It's actually what led to the 1833 Factory Act, which was supposed to reform things for children in factories. And he interviewed a person called Elizabeth Bentley, and her answers, oh, they make me mad. He asked her, he said, what were your hours of labour? And she said, as a child, I worked from 5 a.m. till 9 p.m. And then he said, what time was allowed for meals? We were allowed 40 minutes at noon. He said, had you any time to get breakfast or drinking? No, we got it as we could. Did you have time to eat it? No. We were obliged to leave it or to take it home. And when we did not take it, the overlooker took it and gave it to the pigs.
Apprentices are fed and housed here, and they work in return. But they're not allowed to come and go from home as they want to.
No freedom at all. Well, do what they're told. You get up when you're told, you go to work when you're told, you come back to eat when you're told.
Part of the deal of working as an apprentice was that lodgings and food were provided for the duration of your contract.
One of the staples is porridge. This was breakfast, really, and it would be cooked until it was incredibly thick, so much thicker than this. In the early days of the mill, the porridge would be taken up to the children to eat. They would have the porridge thick enough to just be put in their hand, either as a slice or as a dollop.
Yeah, and it works, doesn't it? You don't need a bowl.
No.
Cold porridge.
Yeah, but cold, it will keep porridge. You going.
Cold porridge may not sound very appetising, but compared with other poor children at the time, Quarry Bank's apprentices were pretty well fed.
There were cases of enormous abuse at both mills and workhouses where children were dying of malnutrition. Here, they seem to have done quite well.
Thank you.
your apprentices. Orphans and bastards. No one will listen to you. So say nothing.
Quarry Bank, and yeah. Scenes that we've done where we get locked in the attic,
yeah,
they were locked in this attic.
Doing some of the scenes in the rooms that in which the events took place is the strangest thing.
Yeah,
definitely. The things that I'm often to do, she, this was her life.